Hello, and welcome to the first in our series on all things Microsoft and artificial intelligence. This is AI Academy.
Here you can expect to not only learn about AI, not only to see it in action, but to understand how it fits into normal modern life.
No matter what your hobbies are, what your workday looks like, or how you spend time with friends and family, AI Academy has valuable stories, examples, and scenarios that you can make use of right away.
In fact, it's safe to say that there's almost never been another technology that has evolved and innovated as rapidly as AI has.
So keep checking back here at AI Academy regularly. We're creating content often, and the sooner you experience it, the more up-to-date you'll be on Microsoft Copilot's incredible AI experiences, features, and capabilities.
So, what can you expect to find in this series? Well, you'll learn all about Microsoft's everyday AI companion, Microsoft Copilot, and how you can not only find Copilot, but use it to make the everyday easier. You'll learn how tools like Copilot can elevate your daily productivity and give you a creative boost when you most need it. You'll also learn about other AI enhancements throughout different Microsoft tools and services.
Let's kick off with a baseline. What is AI, and how can we better understand this new technology and how versatile an AI assistant can be? And that is just the tiniest tip of what AI can do right now. Let's dive in and understand more about what AI is as it exists today, and more importantly, how it works. By now, you probably don't give a second thought to the fact that your music streaming app knows what song you want to hear next, or the website you're shopping on somehow recommends the perfect product to tempt you. These recommendations are, at their essence, algorithms. Don't be afraid of that word. Ready for the easiest definition of algorithm ever? It's a set of rules, admittedly sometimes very complex rules, that computers follow, like a massively intricate game of 20 questions. If an algorithm is trained well enough, it can become what we recognize as generative AI, which means it can actually engage in nuanced conversation, create images, and even videos.
Okay, let's just say the thing. For a lot of people, AI can be synonymous with dystopian sci-fi doom and gloom. Sci-fi books and movies haven't exactly given AI the most positive rep. Just know this, AI is, yes, an advanced algorithm. It is not a conscious thinking entity with original thoughts and actions. It only works when given instruction or permission by you. It's software. I hope you are as excited about AI as I am, but guess what? As of 2023, over 70% of people over the age of 45 were unsure if AI is even a good thing for society. So the point is, when you don't understand AI, you can easily view it as something different to what it really is.
So what is it? Well, if you're chatting back and forth with AI, that's probably an LLM. You know how your phone can guess what word you want to text next? An LLM, a large language model, is essentially that same technology, but just ramped up to 11. It generates words that are relevant to the input you gave it. Seriously, that's fundamentally how it works. Then how does it seem so smart? It's all about the training. These LLMs are trained on vast data sets, including complete libraries of books, articles, and websites. This is how these AI tools can understand and generate human-like language so effectively. Versatility is key. These LLMs are being trained in an always growing suite of tasks like translation, summarization, Q&A, creative writing, and on and on and on. More abilities are being added and discovered literally every day.
If this is sounding too technical, just remember, the use case scenarios for AI are just about as broad as the number of use case scenarios for any technology ever. Think about the number of times you would have liked an extra set of eyes on an email or a Word document.
The difference it would make to have a personal researcher do all the digging around about two different products that you've been comparing.
The last time you planned a big trip and how many websites, blogs, reviews, and apps you used to make an itinerary that fit within your budget.
These normal life scenarios are where these AI tools can shine brightest and have the strongest impact on our lives. All it takes is that you become familiar with how to use them.
The AI we interact with, like Microsoft Copilot, has been trained on human behavior. Whenever someone isn't very impressed with AI, it's often because they're treating it like a sci-fi robot instead of a nuanced algorithm like it really is.
And it's not just what you say, it's how you say it. Look at how different the output is if I ask AI, top five weekend activities versus if I ask it, I'm a busy dad and I want to have fun with my high energy kiddos this weekend. What are five things we should consider to have fun together?
Look at the difference. Curiosity, openness, and strong questioning skills really go a long way.
So AI, it isn't the Matrix. It's a valuable tool to learn right now.
You want to become an AI master in record time? It's easy. Here's how. The next time you start to search for something online, try using Copilot instead. That's it. Use it for your everyday tasks, and then you'll start understanding the full scope of what it can help you with.
And when at first you don't succeed, explain to Copilot what it got wrong and let it try again. Have fun, stay curious, and get ready to save a lot of time in your day-to-day tasks.
In our next AI Academy installment, we'll talk about how Microsoft has made a commitment to responsible AI principles. It's very interesting. See you then.